Gibson was formally charged today with two counts of murder after being an habitual offender. WRKY's Marissa Alter is live at the Floyd County Courthouse with the developments. Marissa?
Developments, Vicki, that Floyd County prosecutor Keith Henderson himself calls surprising. William Clyde Gibson is now accused of killing 75-year-old Christine Whitis last week, as well as 45-year-old Karen Hodella in October 2002. Gibson is now behind bars at the Floyd County Jail without bond.
The apprehension, I believe, of Mr. Gibson, the good work of the detectives and the police, particularly Kerry East, we have someone off the street. That was a danger to the community.
Now, Gibson first got on detectives' radar last Thursday when Christine Whitis was found dead in his New Albany home on Woodbourne Drive. Today, we learned she was strangled to death, discovered by Gibson's relatives in the garage. Whitis knew Gibson's mother. They were lifelong friends, and we're told she actually knew Gibson since he was born. Police believe she went over to his home to see him when something went wrong. Gibson was picked up for questioning later that day, driving Whitis's vehicle. During the investigation, we're told Gibson implicated himself in Whitis's death and in a cold case from 9.5 years ago. 45-year-old Karen Hodella of Clarksville went missing in October 2002. Her body was found in the Ohio River a few months later. Police say Hodella and Gibson knew each other from the bar scene and had a consensual short-term relationship. They cannot confirm how she died due to the condition of her body, but they do believe the murder happened in Floyd County. Gibson is a sex offender with a long criminal record, including convictions in Jefferson County for sexual abuse, felony assault, robbery, and wanton endangerment.
We always look for motive as to why. People want to know why. And, you know, in some cases, we don't know why, nor can we tell. But we do know and we feel confident that with this probable cause and now with his incarceration, that the community is safer today.
Now, police believe, they say that they have had a hard time making contact with any of Hodella's family, but they do say they will continue to keep trying. As for Whitis's family, they were in the courtroom today to see Gibson formally charged. They spoke with us after that court hearing. You'll hear from them tonight on WLKY News at 11. Live in New Albany, Marissa Alter, WLKY News.